Facing reality is tough in a world decorated by facades where escapism is sport and socializing is but an ego competition perpetrated by our media obsession. Marcus Thompson II. This is Simone Biles, one of the greatest of our generation. In 2020, Simone Biles dropped out of the Olympics due to a mental health battle she was having. And instead of the media sending positivity her way, they bashed Biles, calling her names like weak-minded, a disappointment, and even called her not a real athlete, when in reality, she owes us nothing. Good afternoon. My name is Lila Pimes, and today I'll be discussing public perception on female athletes. My research question is, to what extent does the minimal coverage of women's sports in comparison to men impact the public perception of female athletes? My argument is, due to the unfair ratio of media coverage in sports, women receive less attention and support from the public than their male counterparts. Due to this, lack of coverage induces less support and less recognition, which leads to less funding opportunities.
Kate Sletcher.
For example, in 2019, UN Women 2020 reported that only 7% of global sponsorships were allocated towards female athletes and teams, while other reports showed that lucrative sponsorship deals are awarded with 5 times as high as frequency towards males compared to female athletes, which isn't fair, because these perceptions are holding back opportunities for women, contributing to the idea that women's sports have no support. According to an NCAA report, women receive 40% or less of college athletic funding. Division I athletic departments fund men's at 2 times the rate as women's, creating a $35 million gap between them. Even though in 2022, the women's NCAA basketball championships drew a bigger television audience than men's for the first time ever, bringing in over $1.2 billion in revenue, which shows the complexity of this issue generally leads to the biases and slow pace of changes in gender equality. This impacts the overall perception of women's sports when it comes to funding. In addition to this, negative stereotypes can also majorly impact public perception because the public is given the idea that male sports are more important. If we are mainly seeing men in the public will overall pay little interest to women. According to exposure to women's sports, changing attitudes towards female athletes, many sports fans argue that women's sports are boring compared to men's. Many sports fans argue, simultaneously, women's sports compared to men's sports are less desirable by giving them less coverage. This is showing that simply women just don't get enough airtime, so fans will just not be interested. It isn't fair to say that it's boring when the reality is that it's the media's fault and not these athletes. Another negative stereotype is that women are being sexualized and objectified. As you can see in this picture, the girls are wearing literally bathing suits when real men who play football wear padding. This is because they're trying to shift the narrative. These girls are being forced to wear bikinis, which is unfortunately shifting the focus from their athleticism and hard work so the public can watch these girls run around in small outfits that are sexualizing. According to Kaylee Dickinson, she states that female athletes are underrepresented in the media. When people see female athletes on television, they may not take them seriously or pay attention to the content of their interviews or pay attention because they are too distracted by the athletes' appearances. This problem boils down to the inequalities that women face, which shows how the audiences focus on things that don't matter, rather focusing on things like elite skill, impeccable athleticism, and achievements, which can overall sabotage female athletes' representation and subtract from their credibility. The lack of female coverage has a negative impact on young girls who are athletes or are interested in sports, because it's a lack of representation. Girls need to see that they can achieve big things too. When they see women athletes succeeding, it inspires them to go for their own goals, so if they aren't seeing enough of it, then it could really affect the way that they think about themselves. According to Julian Arendt, she says that presently there's a lack of available female role models through personal interactions or displayed in the media, which may contribute to the low perceived sport competence and high levels of gender role conflicts of young women athletes, ultimately leading to their withdrawals from sports. The presence of older female role models can create positive impact of role models for emotions and thoughts for children about their sports participation. This is due to the lack of media representation. It is harder for children to see them If the new generation of young girls can't see these strong, skilled women competing and winning, it is harder for them to be able to imagine themselves doing the same. Not to mention, young boys grow up with video games, and they it's way easier for them to see their favorite athletes on TV, whereas girls don't have it the same way. In a study done by Janice J. Crosswit, it was explained that when young girls were asked to nominate the role models, girls overwhelmingly chose a female role model. However, when the role model came from the sporting domain, the percentage of female role models decreased. The study's explaining how girls are more likely to pick a woman role model because it's more relatable. But when it comes to sports, they're probably forced to pick a male role model just because they just don't see enough of it. There just aren't as many female athletes that should be shown, and this is why there needs to be more female athletes that are visible. So, some solutions to resolve this problem are educating the audiences. When we educate and engage the audiences about the importance of women's sports and gender equality through informative articles and campaigns to raise awareness, we also need to advocate for change, raising awareness and supporting initiatives that promote changes in gender equality. So that way, these young girls growing up will have more of a bigger selection of role models that they'll be able to grow up with. And supporting women leagues. Providing coverage of leagues and tournaments can significantly increase the visibility for female athletes by broadcasting more, providing more athletic updates, promoting through different channels, more endorsements. So that way, these girls can see these female athletes all the time, so that way they know that they are being represented. Now, some of the possible limitations are that the lack of sources and investments. As we discussed, that girls aren't seen as much on TV as guys are, so it could create less funding and investments, which can limit the quality of production and promotion of women events. They might not be as big as the males events, but if we get more investors, then that could be good. Broadcasting scheduling, because women's sports events may be aired less at less favorable times compared to men's, which could create a lack of interest and views. And media biases. Media organizations may prioritize covering more popular men's sports than women's sports, pushing women's sports to secondary coverage, which we're seeing right now. Thank you.
All right, two questions for you. First up, how valid and reliable were your sources that you used, and how do you know they were?
The sources that I used, I got them from EBSCO, so I just chose the academic journals that I thought were best.
All right, and if you have more time, what additional research would you do on this?
I think I would have really looked into like the gender wage gap, because in sports there's a really big difference between how much the guys get paid and how much the girls get paid. So if I had more time, I would have definitely looked into it, but time just got in the way.